Now, the twin ideas of heaven and hell have endured for millennia, though how they are described varies on the local culture. And in the 21st century, hell is rarely spoken about anymore. Bart Ehrman is the author of Heaven and Hell, A History of the Afterlife. Bart, good afternoon to you.
Hi, good afternoon.
Did heaven and hell feature much in the Old Testament?
No, that's the striking thing. I mean, I don't know what the situation in Ireland is, but in America, still a majority of people believe that when a person dies, their soul goes to heaven or to hell. And my book about this that's coming out argues that, in fact, that idea is not in the Old Testament at all. And I also argue it's not what Jesus taught. And so, you know, the question I have is, you know, where did the idea come from then?
Is there, strictly speaking, in Judaism, does Judaism believe in an afterlife?
Well, you know, Jews are like Christians. They, you know, they believe a wide range of things. But the traditional Jewish view is that there is not that there's punishment after death or reward after death, but that it's all about life in the present. And so in the Old Testament, most of the Old Testament just assumes that when you die, you're dead, and that's the end of the story. And that's a little bit depressing for some of the Old Testament authors, but they take that as just a reality of life. The life just goes on as long as you breathe.
Yeah, no, so Jesus, and at the time Jesus was on earth, Jesus was technically still a Jew, and would have been regarded at that time as just a group of Jews. So the belief then, the contemporary belief then, was that there was no heaven and hell.
No, by the time of Jesus, things had changed. So the Old Testament was finished some centuries before Jesus was around, and by that time, many Jews had come up with a different idea, which was that that there is justice in the world, so that if you're a good person, you are going to be rewarded, and if you're a schmuck, you're going to be destroyed. And so the idea in Jesus' time that was widely held, that he himself held, was that at the end of history, God was going to destroy all the forces of evil in the world and take away all the pain and suffering, and he was going to raise people from the dead. Those who had been opposed to him, he was going to destroy violently, and those who were on his side, he was going to bring into a new kingdom here on earth. And so it would not be life in heaven in the soul, it would be life here on earth in the body. And so that's where the idea of the resurrection of the body came from, which is a view that Jesus held to.
Right, so when one dies then, what they were teaching was that when you die, your soul didn't go to heaven.
That's right.
But that there would be a kind of a nothing period until you were physically resurrected.
Yeah, well, Jesus doesn't actually say anything about the nothing period, and in part it's because he appears to have thought that resurrection of the dead was going to happen pretty soon. And so he wasn't too worried about what happens in the meantime, because it's going to happen pretty quickly, and that was the view of his followers too. The Apostle Paul had just that view. He thought that the end of the world was going to come very soon, and so he wasn't too worried about what happens in the meantime.
Because I suppose the depictions of hell only make, especially the older depictions of hell, only make sense if it's a physical resurrection, if you're being physically tortured.
Well, this is the irony of the whole thing, is that in a number of the depictions, they claim that the body rots in the grave and the soul lives on, and yet they talk about the torture of the soul. And it's not just like a mental anguish, it's actual, you know, in fire and burning. And so there's this kind of irony that it's interesting, because a lot of people today still have the same idea. It's your soul that lives on, but it can be physically punished. And a lot of people just haven't thought about, you know, how can a being that has no nerve endings suffer pain?
Yeah.
So, it is one of those ironies. Yeah.
And hell itself, would it be true to say, now, obviously, you're in the US, and that's probably more religious now than Europe would tend to be.
Yes, but
even in the US, more people believe in heaven than believe in hell, which one assumes you can infer there's at least a proportion of people who would be people of belief, but only really believe in heaven.
That's exactly right. And I think it's because what's happened is people started realizing that, you know, on one hand, if you just die and there's no afterlife, then it doesn't really make sense, because there's no justice then and it's not fair. But it's also not fair that if you lead a crummy life for 30 years and are wicked, that you get tortured for 30 trillion years, and that's just the beginning. I mean, that's not fair either.
Yeah.
And so people started getting away from the idea of hell, and have, but still like the idea of eternal reward. reward, and so that's why more people believe in heaven than in hell.
Yeah, but even I certainly my impression that mainstream Christian religions in Europe certainly either don't mention hell at all or certainly don't want to stress on it, because all that, like, God taking vengeance all sounds a bit Old Testament and not the kind of happy and inclusive, you know, folk mass type image they want to project.
Well, that's probably right. I think the only place where it's emphasized, even in Europe, are in very conservative evangelical circles, which still exist, especially in England. I don't know about Ireland, but, you know, there are people who believe in a literal hell. Mm. But it's not like an old style religion of the 19th century where fire and brimstone was the order of the day.
Now, and anybody's kind of looked into this will know that a lot of religious ideas, there's an awful lot of cross-pollination that comes in, and angels and resurrection and all these kind of ideas pop up in all sorts of religions around the world. Who has the worst hell?
Yeah, you know, actually, it's pretty interesting when you look at the history of the issue. This is one of the things I deal with in my book is how hell progresses over time. And I think the Christians are the ones who came up with the worst. There are a number of accounts of people who take trips to the afterlife. That is another subject in my book, where people actually take physical journeys and they see what it's like. And in the Christian versions, hell is very graphic, with lurid detail about what kinds of punishments go on eternally for what kinds of sins. And before that, there wasn't too much of that in Greek or Roman or Jewish writings, but the Christians ended up perfecting that.
Bart, thanks very much for speaking with us today. That's Bart Ehrman there. He's the author of Heaven and Hell, A History of the Afterlife. That book is going to be published in March of this year.